Prayers and Meditations, page 2, 19, 12. So long as one element of the being, one moment of the thought, is still subjected to outside influences, not solely under thine, it cannot be said that the true union is realized. There is still the horrible mixture without order and light, for that element, that moment is a world of disorder and darkness, as is the entire earth in the material world, as is the material world in the entire universe. December 3, 1912. Last night, I had the experience of the effectivity of confident surrender to Thy guidance. When it is needful that something should be known, one knows it, and the more passive the mind to Thy illumination, the clearer and the more adequate is its expression. I listen to thee as thou spokest in me, and I would have liked to write on what thou saidst, so that the formula in all its precision might not be lost. For now I should not be able to repeat what was said. Then I thought that this care for conservation was again an insulting lack of confidence towards thee. For thou canst make of me all that I need to be, and in the measure in which my attitude allows thee to act on me and in me, thy omnipotence has no limits. To know that at each instant what must be surely is as perfectly as is possible for all those who know how to see thee in everything and everywhere. No more fear, no more uneasiness, no more anguish, nothing but a perfect serenity, an absolute confidence, a supreme, unwavering peace.